He got hurt during the Boston series, as we know, injured a knee. And then in game two of the Montreal series, he felt the other knee twinge somewhat. And I'm convinced that he's having trouble.
Assisted all the way in. It's 1-0 Pittsburgh. Gut check time for the Isles. Tom. Scorer in the playoffs of the NHL. He's in on Tom Barrasso. The Isles show pluck, but Barrasso keeps stopping the puck. Back to Buffalo and Tom Meese.
That's the situation with under 5 minutes to go in the second period on Long Island. Let's take a look at the last Buffalo scoring chance.
Randy Wood on the puck. He knows he better put the puck towards the goal. And you see number 41, that's a defenseman, Sutton, in looking for the puck. And it's been a very calm game by Patrick Waugh. Very steady.
Flex off of Larry Murphy and past Tom Barrasso. It seems that's about the only way that you're going to beat Barrasso tonight. It is 1-1 down on the island in the closing moments of the second period.
Zone and Flatley shoots in. Barrasso gloved that one. Knocked it down for Ramsey. Ramsey around, lost it to Fitzgerald, but play is stopped, and a penalty will be called here against the New York Islanders. Ramsey was decked in the near corner, and the Islanders will draw their second penalty, and we will see Mario Lemieux, I'm sure, now on the tail end of period number two. As the Penguins will have the turkey on the table and an opportunity here to try.
I don't really know where the high stick was from Claude Loiselle. Looked like Ramsey just got tripped up as he came around the corner. Maybe Fitzgerald got the stick up. That's why Loiselle looks so puzzled. He didn't know, what did I do? And he goes to the box.
Murphy tried to cut him off. He centered it, and it came off Barrasso's stick. Penguins will have a minute 10 to work with as the period will go by that clock and time left. Jágr flying through to the Islanders in, and it's cut off by Brian Mullen. Penguins have yet to score a power play goal in this series. They are 0 for 13. This is power play chance number 4. And Jágr leads the parade on down the right wing of the Islanders in. He's flying. Comes out in front of Lemieux, and he shoots at him. Was blocked. Picked up by Mullen in front for Larry Murphy. Murphy trying to pull the trigger. He can't do it. Jágr gets it again. Top of the right wing circle. Jágr now moving over to Joe Mullen. Slippery rock Joe looking. He tries to put it in front, and it comes off a stick right to Ron Francis at the left point. Back down to the near corner for Joe Mullen. In front for Lemieux, and it went by. Murphy trying to get a handle. Can't. Here come the Islanders shorthanded. 2-on-1. Make it 3-on-1. Fitzgerald left side against Francis. Fitzgerald looks for Ben Mahoga's shot. And he fanned on it. It went off the heel of his stick. He's got it again. Comes out. Shoots it. And off Jágr's blade, and goes over to the far corner. 19 to go in the period. A steal by Fitzgerald. He fires and scores. Tom Fitzgerald with a shorthanded goal.
Third shorthanded goal for the Islanders in this series against the Penguins. Fitzgerald knocked that puck out of the air as the Penguins tried to go up the middle with it out of their own zone. He turned around and just fired it back past Tom Barrasso to give the Islanders their first lead of the hockey game, 2-1.
And the native of Melrose, Mass, is a pretty happy guy right now. And a hit of stick, I think, is deflected by Barrasso again. But a shorthanded goal. Couldn't score in a 3-on-1, but they make it work as they kept right on coming. This Islander team is a team that just never gives up. 16.1 seconds left here in this period.
Derek King still looking for that first playoff goal. Not against Barrasso, not tonight so far. Coming down, Brad Delgarno, rink-to-rink pass, is going to make the shot, Barrasso down, easy save, gives it to his defenseman, out of trouble. Flatley's going to try a little stuffer here in the backhand, Barrasso post-to-post, very securely, just picks it up, hangs on to it, as Ferraro comes in, gives him a little tap, the Islanders frustrated, King with a hit there, and then a little extra hit on Tom Barrasso, because Barrasso's been stoning him the entire series. You don't win Stanley Cups without terrific goaltending.
Scored late in period number two, a shorthanded goal, and he gets a second one here early in the third, 25 seconds in.
Larry Murphy tried to come over and play him on it, and he just fired it right past Barrasso on the glove side.
Well, he just cranked it up and beat him far post, and the Islanders lead 3-1. And the Penguins will
put Lemieux on the bench and go to work here. Down by two.
All right. Well, it was the Isles who had the tough power play going in, but now it's Pittsburgh's power play that's killing them. Tom Fitzgerald with bookend goals and a 3-1 lead. Back to Tom Meese in Buffalo.
All right, Jack Edwards, thank you very much. So the score is identical. Both games in New York State tonight are 3-1. One has the home team winning. The other one has the home team facing elimination. Paul Steigerwald of the Penguins Network had a great line. Maybe the Penguins ought to start declining the penalties.
Well, Pittsburgh gave up 19 shorthanded goals during the regular season. No one gave up more. And it looks like they're having problems in that area as the Islanders are feeding the Islanders.